It's Mr. Get That Bag, yeah.
G5 Jeff TV, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, hit the share button as you come on in. Big shout out to Classic Apparel. Big shout out to the We All From brand. Big shout out to Music Soar. Those are the sponsors of the channel. All the information is in the description box. And follow your boy on Instagram and Twitter at Boxwood G5 Jeff TV. Now, my main man, AB, put a post up on Instagram recently, and he said for him to come back to boxing, he need at least $10 million. And the message was to Al Haymon and the head of Showtime Boxing, Stephen Espinoza. Now, when people read it, people was like, man, Broner ain't worth $10 million. I ain't giving Broner no $10 million. When the last time he won a fight? This, that, and the third. Now, when I read it, I kind of just laughed it off, because anything Broner puts up on social media, like, you just got to take it with a grain of salt. Like, it is what it is. Like, he's a comedian. Like, he's a must-follow on social media, period. Like, one of my favorite people to follow on social media. But when I actually sat and thought about it, I was just like, okay, AB don't play when it come down to his money. I'm like, I think he dead serious about getting this $10 million. So I actually sat and I thought about it, and I was just like, you know what? I was like, I got the perfect plan for my main man, AB, to get not only the $10 million, but way more than $10 million. And for the people that's listening to this, after you get done listening, make sure AB gets this. I'm not going to send it to him. Make sure he gets this, because I feel like this is the perfect plan for him to get $10+ million. And I'm talking about realistic, feasible, a feasible situation at the end of the day. So he wants $10 million from Al Haymon or Stephen Espinoza to come back. I doubt if Al Haymon gives him $10 million. I doubt if Stephen Espinoza gives him $10 million. I don't think they could put him in a position where they can give him that money and put him in fights where he will be favored to win. You understand what I'm saying? Wanting the money is one thing, but wanting to win and putting yourself in the best position to win, that's something that you also have to factor in. So if Al Haymon and Stephen Espinoza is not going to give him $10 million or whatever Adrian Broner is asking for, I think that Al Haymon needs to allow Adrian Broner to walk across the street. Let him play on the other side of the street. You know what I'm saying? And I'm talking DAZN, Golden Boy, Top Rank, places like that. Allow Adrian Broner to seek all opponents and not just PBC opponents. You understand what I'm saying? And this is with all due respect to Adrian Broner, but you put Adrian Broner up against the top 7 to 10 guys at welterweight, and he would be an underdog. He would be an underdog. Errol Spence, underdog. Manny Pacquiao, he already fought. Keith Thurman, underdog. Sean Porter, he already fought. Danny Garcia, he will be an underdog. Yordanis Ugas, I think he would be an underdog. Boots Ennis, he probably would be an underdog. Jesse Vargas, he might be an underdog. Josecito Lopez, he might be an underdog. Virgil Ortiz, he might be an underdog. So it's a lot of fights for him over there at the PBC, but it's not many where he will be favored in. So this plan that I have for AB, for him to get to his $10 million, plus actually being winnable fights, or fights where he will be favored or is 50-50. Number one, Al Haymon needs to let him play across the street. Number two, I think it'd be smart for Eddie Hearn to bring him to DAZN. I think it'd be very smart for him to go over to DAZN. Now, I know people thinking, oh, well, he could fight Devin Haney. Nah, like, I'm no fool. Like, I know Adrian Broner don't watch his weight too well in between fights. He hasn't fought in a while, so weight is always going to be an issue. And it's not the fact that whether he can or can't make the weight. It's a matter of, can he make it comfortably and be in optimum shape on fight night? That's what it comes down to. So my plan is Adrian Broner, welterweight, 147 pounds. If he's able to go over to the zone, if he's able to go over with Eddie Hearn and Al Heyman gives him the blessing to go ahead and do that. There's three fights where AB can be involved in. They will be entertaining fights, and he will have a chance to win. Number one, Amir Khan, that's number one. The press conferences will be pretty entertaining. That's number one. Number two, that will be a competitive fight inside of the ring and a winnable fight for AB because of Amir Khan and the chin glass that could be all over the ring if he lands flush. And most importantly, that fight could go down to Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia, they paid Amir Khan $10 million to fight Billy Dib. Imagine how much they would pay Amir Khan and Adrian Broner to fight in Saudi Arabia. That's number one. If they was to do that, AB would get his $10 million just off of that one fight. Okay? Let's just say that doesn't happen. All right? The second opponent could be Kell Brook. Kell Brook, good fighter, but he's on the back end of his career. He's been rumored to fight Terrence Crawford. That's a fight he's going to lose. Kell Brook a couple years ago might have gave Terrence Crawford a good run, but I don't see Kell Brook beating Terrence Crawford. Like, that's a suicide fight. But Kell Brook versus Adrian Broner, that's a very entertaining fight, and that's a winnable fight for AB. That's a winnable fight for AB. Right, as of right now, that's a 50-50 fight. That's a 50-50 fight, Adrian Broner, Kell Brook. And that fight could go down in the UK. AB probably could get 10 mil off of a Kell Brook fight in the UK. He probably could. And the third opponent, now, some people think that this opponent would just mop the floor with AB. I'm of different opinion on this, but Virgil Ortiz, he's 15-0, 15 knockouts, hot prospect. He's going to be looking to fight a big name to put himself on the map. And I don't care what's going on with Adrian Broner. Adrian Broner would be a tough matchup for Virgil Ortiz. Now, would he be favored against Virgil Ortiz? No, he wouldn't. But that would be a huge fight for AB. And all three of those is possible if Al Heyman allows Adrian Broner to cross the street. He could not only get $10 million, he probably could get 20 to 30 just off of those three fights alone if he plays it right. But, hey, that's just my personal opinion. That would be my game plan if I was Adrian Broner's manager. But if y'all like this plan for AB, man, get this video over to AB right now. Get this over to AB. At the end of the day, they need to put together a game plan for AB where he's bringing in the most money and he's in winnable fights. And I think you put AB in the ring with Amir Khan, Kell Brook, and then if he can get past them to possibly a Virgil Ortiz, oh man, like he would be in a good light from a boxing perspective. He will be in a good light from a boxing perspective. They will be global matchups because you got UK versus US. And then Virgil Ortiz, all of the young fans love him. And he has a nice fan base as well. So I think it's the perfect game plan for AB. If y'all liked it, if y'all like the game plan, definitely get this video over to AB and AB's people right now. And let's see what he thinks about it. He probably would be like, yo, I can win all three of those fights and hit the bank all at the same time. Y'all let me know what y'all think in the comment section. G5Jeff TV. Hit the subscribe button, hit the like button. Please share this video, support your boy. Support good content at all times. I appreciate y'all. Peace.